Hi everybody. I am going to do an updated skincare routine and I'm going to try to get through it pretty quickly and I'm going to try to not talk about why I think anything is good. I've been using, I did another video, I had been using another product line for about 3 weeks, but I'm going to do a skincare routine based on what I have used for the last 11 years. Most of the products I have used for that long. Some of them were new since then, but yeah, we will get right to this. Okay, so in the morning, I am going to use, sometimes I will just simply rinse my face with tepid water and pat it dry. If I want to wash my face in the morning, I use whatever cleanser, the cleanser du jour, and I have quite a few, but the two that I really like as of late has been the Simple Refreshing Facial Wash Gel or the Aveeno Active Naturals, and this is pore purifying facial wash. So I would use one of these. Anything that is fragrance free, soap free, sulfate free, dye free, anything that is not going to overly dry my skin and overly irritate my skin, then I will wash my face with it. Generally, not soap. After I wash my face, I swap these off every other day. I will use the Dr. Danesse Advanced Firming Facial Pads, or I will use the Pro-C Illuminating Cell Defense Pads, or I will use the SkinCeuticals CE Ferulic, and there is a less expensive version of this that I really do like that I've used before. I just happen to have this at the moment. So one of these, and I do all of this based on what I feel like my skin needs at the moment. So on any given day, I might use the Advanced Firming Facial Pads followed by the CE Ferulic. You really need to evaluate your skin. If my skin is getting too dry, if it's feeling like I'm getting clogged pores, whatever it seems like is going on, then that's kind of what determines what products I kind of grab for in the morning. After that, I use some sort of serum, and which would right now for the last probably 6 months or so, I've been using the Dr. Danesse Cell Renew RX Cell Recharging Gold Serum. If my skin is a little bit drier, and I especially possibly in the winter time, then I might actually go to a heavier moisturizer, which would be the Dr. Danesse Hydro Shield Hydrating Dream Cream or the Clinique Redness Solutions Daily Relief Cream. And then I would follow that with sunscreen, which I put on last. I put on, if it's a physical sunscreen, if it does not need to absorb into my skin to work, this is what I use. I put it over a moisturizer. I want it to be top. These work if they're primarily zinc oxide sunscreens, and I said I wasn't going to talk about all this. If they're primarily zinc oxide, titanium dioxide, physical sunscreens, they work by reflecting light rays. And to me, they are better for anti-aging. And everything that I read, nothing has changed that opinion. So Eucerin, sensitive skin, everyday protection face lotion, SPF 30. This is really more of a favorite. Skin Actives, advanced protection, SPF 30 with Z-Coat. And this, I have to order this online. This I can pick up locally. So sunscreen. And then I put makeup over that. I don't use any kind of primer. This sunscreen actually kind of acts like a primer. So that's morning. At night, I like to remove makeup with a makeup remover. And a makeup remover can be anything. It could be this soothing soy nourishing cleansing milk. It could be the Paula's Choice Resist Optimal Results Hydrating Cleanser. It could be this Clinique Redness Solutions Soothing Cleanser. Whatever type of product it could be oil. I've used olive oil to take makeup off with because I like to take it off, tissue it off, and then wash my skin, at which point I could go back to one of the cleansers I used in the morning, or I could simply wash it a second time with these. But I just like my skin. I just like knowing that my skin is clean. So those are the products that I use to remove makeup and to also wash my face at night. And then to remove eye makeup, I use the Almay Oil-Free Eye Makeup Remover Pads. I still really like these. I also really like this. It is Simple Sensitive Skin Experts Eye Makeup Remover, and I really like this too. This is every bit to me as amazing as the Bioderma. So that gets makeup off, that cleans my face. Next, I would do a toner, and I like this Paula's Choice Skin Recovery Toner for normal to very dry skin. And following that, depending on the night, again, here we go with just depending on. Since I use medications, I use this for rosacea, which is Finacea. On occasion, I use metronidazole. I also, on occasion, use 4% hydroquinone, which is prescription. All of those would be prescription. I may use Atrolin. This is 0.5%. This is a tretinoin product, and it only comes in this percentage. And this, in my humble opinion, is the best tretinoin product on the market. It does not seem to cause the same negative side effects of typical tretinoin products, which would be flaking and peeling and redness and bleh. So I would use that, and I would use this everywhere. I would use it all over my face. I use it up under my eyes. The biggest thing I have to watch with using this is the very corners of my mouth, the corners of my nose, sometimes areas of your face that move a lot. And in my case, it would be my mouth, which according to my husband moves entirely too much. So I would use that, and then I would follow it with, again, whatever I felt like my skin needed. If I wanted to use a serum, I would use this, or I would, on occasion, use the Dr. Denese Hydra Shield Ultra Moisturizing Face Serum. If I feel like I need it. If I feel like I need more than that, I will use, again, the Clinique Redness Solutions or the Hydra Shield Hydrating Dream Cream again. And then I also really like this Dr. Danette's Triple Strength Neck Wrinkle Smoother. And anything, I can't think of anything that I do to my face that I do not also do to my neck, to my décolletage, to the backs of my hands, which would be why these parts of me look so, so much better, and you'll just have to take my word for it, than the rest of my poor old body. If I could afford these products in the gallon size, maybe the rest of me would look better. And let's see, anything else? I've got a couple of new products that I've tried that I have not done a review yet on. And I will try to get a review done of, actually, I think there's 3 new products that I've purchased, and I'll try to get a review done of those soon. And that's all I can think of, and I hope this has not gone on for far too long. If you have any questions, let me know. Just in general, the best thing I can tell you is to try to pay attention to what your skin needs. I don't think it's good to keep our skin in a constant state of inflammation, because then you've got free radical production. You're trying to eliminate free radical situations with the CE ferulic type products. I think we can overdo, so I try to be aggressive but within reason, so that I still, on a daily basis, I still want my skin to look nice. Even though I'm treating it, I still want it to look nice. I want to have a good foundation for makeup, and I don't like to wear a lot of makeup. I have always tried, as much as I've never cared for Philosophy's products, I have always tried to have makeup optional skin. And I feel like I do. It is far from perfect, but if I have to leave the house and all I can get on my face is a little bit of under eye concealer and some sunscreen, I'm good. So yeah, let me know if there's anything I didn't go over, if there's something I missed, if you've got any questions. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye.